That was like the concert I did not know I needed. Welcome to a new vlog. Today is Thursday. Is it Thursday? Yes. Thursday, December 1st. So welcome to December. I'm not doing Vlogmas this year, but I'm gonna be vlogging. So I know I said at the end of my last vlog, I was gonna pick up a new one right then, and I did. But pretty quickly, my voice like disappeared. You guys, I thought I was having just like allergies or something, because I don't know. I just forget that sicknesses other than COVID exist, and I was testing negative for COVID, but I definitely was sick, so I didn't really vlog anything there. I had a couple of pretty rough days. Then Thanksgiving was here. I've just been living in like the biggest time warp, I feel like, because Thanksgiving already, at least for me, I just feel like it's always just like, what day is it? You know, I just get confused. But yes, there was that. And then pretty immediately following Thanksgiving, Giselle got pretty sick as well, but I don't think she got it from me because it was like a lot of time had passed. She spent several days home from work, and I feel like I've been living one giant day for the longest time. And I'm like, what have I been doing? Even though I've been doing a lot, like I actually still have a pretty chill next few days because I've gotten everything done I needed to get done, but it's just felt like a blur is what I'm saying. And that's why I'm picking up this vlog later than I said in the last video. Tonight I have something pretty exciting on the agenda. Every year Spotify, you know, like Spotify Wrapped just came out, and Spotify has like a end of the year Spotify Wrapped party. And last year, Giselle and I went, Gwen Stefani performed. That was like the concert I did not know I needed. I just didn't realize how many songs at first I knew, and it was so much fun. So tonight, we are going along with Caitlin and Alex, and Charlie XCX is gonna be performing, which I'm really excited about because it's very fitting. She was actually my second most listened to artist, right behind Ray, on my Spotify Wrapped. So I just feel like it just makes sense. But I'm just very excited for that. It's gonna be fun. Yesterday, Giselle and I haven't done this in like 2 years, but we rented a studio space in downtown LA to go shoot some fun photos and like a Christmas card photos. That was just fun. We found this pier space. I'll have it linked below, which like, especially in LA, and I'm sure like New York and other like cities, they have just like so many really cool studio rental options. So like I've shot a couple years ago at one that was like this neutral setup. And then this one was called like the Time Machine. So there was like a old school like diner thing that I couldn't really, that one wasn't working for me. They just had a lot of like cool sets. And so I shot like almost all of my brand campaigns for the month. I'm just feeling very ahead. It was only December 1st, and it is the beginning of the month. I think for my main channel this week, I might film like a December reset video. My last final announcement. Yes, I'm stopping. I don't know why I'm not finishing my makeup right now. I guess I should just do the mascara. That's all that's left. The last exciting update is that as of today, when I'm filming this, my group travel trip to Croatia in June of 2023 is going to 3 different cities in Croatia. I'm not going to go through all of it right now, but I'll have that itinerary linked. I've been to all these places a few years ago, and I just love Croatia. I'm very excited because Giselle's never been to Croatia, so the trip is now live. This is very fast turnaround. Some people have already been booking it. The first 8 people, it went on sale like a few minutes ago, but the first 8 people will get $100 off. It is gonna be so much fun. There are only 18 spots total, and I would love for any of you guys to come if you're wanting to go explore Croatia and come alone. Like, everyone's always so friendly on these. Like, people go into this with like a friend-making mindset, you know? So yeah, come with friends, come by yourself, come with your partner, and I'm just very excited for that. So I think it's gonna be a great Thursday. It is also so rainy and dark right now, so that could actually interfere with my filming plans if it's gonna be like pitch black out, which it is. We'll see. Recommendations of the moment. I don't go to regular grocery stores too often, aka not Trader Joe's, but I recently picked up this oat milk cinnamon roll creamer. It is so good. It tastes just like a cinnamon roll. Giselle has been brewing her own cold brew, if you will. Just like, she just knows how to do so many things that are probably not that hard to figure out, but just that I've never even thought about trying to figure out for myself. So I'm just learning something new every day over here, but that's why I put some water in it, was to dilute it a bit because it's a concentrate. Also, today I'm very decked out for the home state today, apparently, and in my grout fit. My t-shirt is also the same thing. Not planned. I'm gonna see how this rain situation and lighting progresses throughout the day. I'm gonna take advantage of the cozy vibes to do some Christmas shopping in general. I missed the Black Friday sales. I was like so rushed, you guys, in getting my gift guide video up. So I did post that. I didn't realize, like, I was like editing it. I was like, why is this video so long? And then I was adding all the links. There are so many items in that gift guide, like twice as much as any other year that I've made, I feel like. So I'll have that linked if you want some present ideas. Every year, I just really pride myself on that video, and I feel like I have some just like creative ideas. My focus was on that during like Black Friday, so I missed the sales for shopping for people in my life for the most part. I haven't been able to do this for days because Giselle has been here, but something I'm getting her that I'm very excited about is an Artifact Uprising, like very big. These are like the signature, like thick pages, like the spreads like lay completely flat, so you can put even a photo like over the crease and it'll look like completely seamless. So obviously we did a lot of traveling this year, so I've been wanting to put together an album showcasing all of the places we went. I have hardly started. I need to go like import a million photos, and I thought for like each city I would have a place like opt for the text option, which I have in the past, to be able to like type in some memories, like things I wanna forever be able to look back on and remember. So this is gonna be time consuming. I'm gonna work on this. Also, my book at the moment that I've been reading, this is quite short. I feel like I'm flying through it. The first shot, if you read The Last Mrs. Parrish, this is like, now I can't remember her name, Amber, like the con artist girl trying to become Miss Parrish. This is like the what's the word for it? I can't think of my words today, but this is the story of like the chapter before that book for like her life, so. Pretty good so far. Lastly, for one more present note, because I just realized we do have kind of a lot of presents over here. These are just for like friends and some stuff for Giselle. I've been wrapping with like this black paper and velvet black ribbon. I think it looks so nice, but I've just been getting so impatient, and every other day I feel like I'm just trying to get her to open something. So I got her like some custom little ornaments. She's already opened most of those. I'm trying to just stay patient for everything else, but we decided the other day we're gonna open one gift each. So what she gave me that I'm thrilled about, because I was saying I wanted more Legos. I don't know what it is, you guys. This is the most therapeutic thing for me. And the other day I was feeling so anxious, and she was like, I want you to open a gift. And she gave me this one, and I've been trying to pace myself because I fly through these, but this is a Harry Potter little Lego set. And it's like from the Triwizard Tournament kind of characters and things going on there. So we ended up watching that movie that night as well. And I felt so much better. Like, I would recommend this, but I just thought this was fun. Also, a new purchase I have been loving. This little book light. This section for the past year has been so empty above this bar cart. And I don't know why I didn't act sooner, but Giselle has been like persistent in wanting something above the bar cart. So we were at World Market the other day. We found this piece and got it like 25% off. It's like a textured, I don't know, like that kind of cementy looking art from Amazon. I wanted a picture light to go above it, and there was no way to like run a cord up to that, so I found a battery powered one, and I think it looks so good. Also, since this is like some textured art, it just gives like some fun shadows and enhances that, I think. So here's what it looks like. Been loving having the little Christmas lights on as well, in case you missed my decorating video. Giselle ended up also hanging garland. Oh, these have lights too. One sec. She hung up all these garlands that were just fresh from Trader Joe's. They are kind of drying out, and I feel like I can tell. Anyways, still looks cute and festive.
I mean, look at how dark it is. It's officially raining, so I don't think filming's gonna be happening today. Another thing that happened since the last vlog. So for Thanksgiving, originally, as in like a month ago, the plan was for three other couples to come over like on Thanksgiving night for like a Thanksgiving dinner. That was gonna be what we did instead of like a big Friendsgiving this year, which honestly turns out being fine how this worked out anyway, because I just was feeling very low effort. The plan was that four couples were all gonna be here and have like a big Thanksgiving dinner. As it got closer, everyone basically ended up deciding to go do things with their families, but me and Giselle were just gonna stay in town just because flights are so expensive. I've actually never, since moving here, gone home for Thanksgiving, and it's so close to Christmas as well that it's like, I'll just spend it once and like stay a little bit longer at Christmas. So on Thanksgiving, we just went to some friends' house for a little brunch, which was fun. And then that night, Giselle and I just went out to dinner at Catch. And so they had like a Thanksgiving plate option, which I'm sure like would have been delicious, but we ended up just getting like their regular food. So we had, I mean, it was delicious, but we had a bunch of like sushi and fish things and like some steak for our Thanksgiving dinner, which I was happy with. And then I guess a couple days later, or the next day, I made a comment to Giselle about how like, I thought we were gonna get Thanksgiving food there, which genuinely I'm indifferent, so I don't really know why I even said that. But Sunday night, so this past Sunday, a few days ago, Giselle was like, I wanna cook you dinner at home for like a date night. And I was like, okay. What we were gonna be having was a surprise and I wasn't allowed to look in the fridge. And so I posted this on TikTok, but what it ended up being was Giselle made like herself a complete Thanksgiving dinner for two people. So obviously we didn't do like a full turkey, but she got like turkey breast and like cooked it up. Everything was so good. We had like these like garlicky mashed potatoes. She made truffle mac and cheese, just forever doing the most. Cranberry sauce she made. Homemade cornbread, stuffing. What made me think to tell the story is that the leftover cornbread is right here. Oh, these like honey balsamic Brussels with like pomegranate seeds and like pancetta. It's very elaborate. A lot of you guys were commenting on the TikTok being like, Chef Giselle strikes again. But that was just very thoughtful and a highlight of my past few days. On the menu for breakfast, nothing new around here. I've either been having avocado toast, like as always, or Giselle has been making homemade pesto for a while lately. So sometimes I'll do pesto toast where I just put pesto in the pan and then like crack the egg in there and then just top that with some chili flakes and that's it. Also for Christmas, she gave me some box cutters because I'm forever ruining scissors by opening all of my mail. But yeah, it's just been a wonderful past couple of weeks. I feel like November went by slowly, but like in a good way. I haven't felt stressed in a while. I've just been like really having just some good chill time, I feel like.
Here we have it. Also, you guys, I saw these at Trader Joe's. Yesterday, I cannot stop eating these little butter cookies. I don't know why I have such a specific memory of when I was a child, like my childhood pediatrician, every time I'd go to the doctor, at the end you like got to take a cookie and it was always these butter cookies. I don't know why I still just think they're so delicious. So right now I am in such a daze. It's already like 3 p.m. You guys have been working on this photo album and other stuff, but like mostly this all day, literally all day. It's my fault that I don't have a good system for like storing all my photos in general. So I've been digging through like a million photos on my phone, sending them here, trying to like make all the decisions for the layouts. And then like, I don't know, like here's a sample page and these are gonna end up printing very big. Like one half of this, like the book itself is 10 by 10. So this is a very big album and I'm not done. I've only been through like half the cities. And just from staring at the screen, I feel like I am in such a daze. I need to snap out of it. I think I'm gonna go upstairs and do a quick workout. Now almost dinner time. Yeah, it's like 6 p.m. We just did like an hour, very low intensity workout. Basically, we just watched a show. What was it called? Oh, what was it called? Okay, pause. We started watching the show called The Mole on Netflix. I just like having a little brain power reality show to watch when I do the treadmill.
You heard how to do a lime? I mean, how to zest lemon the right way?
No. But on the menu tonight for dinner before we go see Charlie, we're having a salmon with like a bunch of dill and basil on top. It's very good. It's a half-baked harvest recipe, like a honey, olive oil, lemon, cayenne like mixture on top. And then we're gonna roast some Brussels sprouts with tzatziki, which our Trader Joe's has been out of tzatziki like the past two or three times we've went. So we decided to try the vegan one and our taste test, and we thought it was pretty good. And then we're gonna have some sauteed mushrooms. Mm-hmm. Caitlin is messaging me about what the heck to wear tonight. And Giselle just made what kind of coffee?
It's toasted marshmallow.
Toasted marshmallow?
Mm-hmm. It's just espresso, oat milk, toasted marshmallow syrup, vanilla bean paste, and vanilla syrup.
Oh, casual. All right, let's try it. Cheers.
Ooh, that's yummy.
It tastes like an espresso martini but without alcohol. Go figure. It's coffee.
Yummy, yummy, yum.
Thank you.
That's good.
I like it. Thank you. All right. This is dinner that I'm speed eating. We have this salmon over here, some sauteed mushrooms, roasted broccoli, and the vegan tzatziki. Definitely tastes vegan, but pretty good.
Watch Alex, like,
all of himself.
guys, it has been a morning. It is rainy again. I intended to vlog a bit more last night, but thought it'd be a good idea to cook a good healthy dinner before going to that event, and I really did not have the time to do that. I was rushing to get ready. The Spotify party was so much fun. Paris Hilton did like a little DJ set. I really like her. I watched her documentary. I would recommend that if you haven't seen it. Just like I have like some genuine respect for her, but that was fun. She did like a long set. Charlie XCX. So last year, Gwen Stefani did like an hour thing. Charlie did like three songs and she left and we were like, she just like ran off very quickly, very suddenly. And we were like, what's happening? Is that like, is there an emergency? Is this the end? But it was the end. So totally fine. It was fun to see her. And then we just hung out at the event. They had like carnival games and yeah, it was a good time. And then we wandered to another bar, good times at Davey Wayne's or something like that. For some reason, I was getting that confused with Dave and Buster's. Thought we were going there, but that was a fun little bar. And there, Caitlin and I strategically for the first time like ever in my life. Not, that's not true, but I'm such a lightweight. I'm very good about just not drinking in general because I really, especially lately, I don't love the feeling of like being, lately even being tipsy. Like as soon as I start to feel tipsy, I think it's like an anxiety thing. It kind of stresses me out and I'm like, I need that to go away. Like I just want to feel like normal. So lately I just especially have not been drinking a lot, but I'm such a lightweight that I can have one drink and it's like, I feel it so much and then it like affects my judgment for realizing like, oh, I probably don't even need another one right now, you know? So I had like, I think three last night. So I was feeling it and thank God for the first time ever, this is what I was gonna say. Me and Caitlin were at the bar and we like broke off, imagine, from Alex and Giselle and like went to the other end of the bar and like sneakily ordered a mocktail. And it was so good, it was great. And thank God I have not had the most productive morning, haven't been feeling 100%. I just feel like very tired because we did get back at like 1 from that. So we were out much later than I ever stay out. Another reason I just have really not been loving drinking lately, and again, this is like also definitely tied to anxiety, is that like it affects my sleep so much. So all last night, which is probably also why I'm so tired, I wake up so many times in the middle of the night with like my heart racing, like it's immediately like just my heart pounding, and it feels like that until I like fully sober up like the next morning. So it's just not my favorite thing lately. Happy Friday, slow start, but it's nice cozy vibes.